Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And someone asks, why were they getting an error when they were trying to do row-level security and object-level security in a single data model? Want to know how we fixed it? Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. Okay. Almost fail. Okay. Row level security, object level security. Can they work in a single data model? Sure they can. But I need to talk about the scenario I faced and how we fixed it. So working with someone, they had a table they were trying to secure at the row level. So let's say they had country and they wanted to say Patrick can access United States, Adam can access France, and then John Doe could access Australia. And they said, we did dynamic row level security. You guys have a lot of content. You actually have a course out there. You can go watch those videos, take the course if you want to, but it's all out there. That was easy. We just did dynamic row level security. But we had another requirement where we needed to secure a column. We didn't want John Doe to see our customer's street address. While he's a great online salesman, can't give him people's addresses and for reasons we don't want to discuss. And I'm like, all right, you can do it. They said, well, Patrick, we tried it. It doesn't work. I was like, show me. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So they said, let me show you the data model and how we set all this up. So they said, we're trying to secure the employee table. Like if you go look at the data, they have an employee table with two employees. There was obviously more employees. And they took the employee ID and they made a one-to-many relationship between that and the sales territory table and said, all right, we're going to add RLS here. So Patrick can see the regions on these rows. And then John Doe could see the regions or countries on these rows. They said, but we also need to secure this street address and we don't want John Doe to see this. And he's like, let me show you what we did. We went and we created two roles. So we created one role with role level security following your guidance, and we have dynamic role level security. I'm like, yep, yeah, perfect. And then we created another role where we fired up the tabular editor. And you know how you can set object level security at the table level? I'm like, yep, you choose a table, you go down here, object level security, it lists all the roles in your model, and then you can turn it on from default to none. I'm like, yeah, I said we didn't do it at the object level, we did it at the column level, same setup, but instead we went to the OLS role and we changed it from default to none. And then we click save. And then we went back over here and we did a test. We created this page right here to show how this would work. So they turned it on and then they enabled both and they got this error. And this is actually a really good error. It says the selected combination of roles is not supported because role level and object level security cannot be combined from different roles. There's a doc, but it's based on analysis services. And I'll put a link where in the description below. And it actually says that in the documentation. It's like, well, how do we fix it? Let me show you. So let's head back over here to manage roles. We're gonna rename this guy. We're gonna call it and RLS. And we're gonna go right here, copy this, go here, go to employee and paste that right there. And we're gonna keep both of these roles because we're gonna add John Doe to this role. And then we're gonna add everyone else who doesn't need the address secured to this role. You can't add people to both roles because you're gonna try to fire off RLS in one role and RLS and OLS in another role. So you'll be back in the same situation. So you need to make sure that if you put a person in one role that you don't put them in the other role. So we did that, and now if you go view as roles and you fire this one off, the RLS will kick in. So you'll see it's only showing for Patrick because that's who I'm signed in. The only countries I can see is United States, and we'll come back to this in a little bit. And then this is broken because it includes a column that I don't have access to. So it's broken because it's included in this visual. But before I show you how to fix that, there's one more thing I want to mention about object level security. So take a look here in the internet sales fields list, I have a measure that references customer address. Then in my customer table, I have a column for street address. If I go back and view as my OLS and RLS role, pay attention to distinct address and street address, boom, distinct address is gone. And that is because this is an indirect effect of object level security. If a measure depends on a column, that measure is also hidden from the report to consumer or someone that's accessing that data set. So that's where this little table came into play. And a big shout out to Gilbert Q over at 4Move for putting this together. This is the first time I read about this, and you can go read his blog post. I'll get a link to it and put it in the description. And what he did was he created a table called report pages. And you can see right here, I'm number one and John Doe's number two. So I can see general information and OLS included. I can see these two. And then John can see OLS columns excluded, and general information. And so what I did was I used the actions on a button combined with a single select slicer to create this kind of dynamic navigation. And so you notice all my pages are hidden. So when I publish this out to the service, you won't be able to explicitly navigate these pages. You'll have to navigate using my buttons. And so if I go to viewer's role now, because it's me, you'll see that I will be able to go to the OLS columns included and general, but I'm just instantiating that it's still broken. But if I just go to the role that I'm going to be a part of, which is just the RLS role, because no one is securing address for me, you'll notice how I go to the OLS columns included. Boom, everything works. If you want to avoid that ugly little X on your visual, for someone that doesn't have access to a particular column, you need to design a page that doesn't include the secured columns. For people that can see them, you'll design another page, and then you'll use this type of pattern to avoid that ugly error. Now, this page security is not security. It's just controlling page navigation. So don't consider this security. And at the end of the video, I'll show you why this is not security. So once I'm all done, I'll publish this up to the service. And I want to show you a few things that even some of the most seasoned people with Power BI kind of stumble on. So once you publish this to Power BI, you need to make a decision. Are you going to give people access via a workspace? You need to make sure you don't assign them to any other role besides a viewer. So if I wanted to give John Doe access to the workspace, I would make him a viewer and add it. But I'm not doing that because as a best practice, we at Guardian Cube and even Microsoft says this, you should distribute your content via an app. So I'm going to create an app. This is secured data. And then I'm going to go to navigation. That's fine. And permissions. And so I'm going to add John Doe here. And I don't want him to copy the reports, but I do want to provide him with build permissions to the data set. And I'll show you why. And so we're going to click publish the app, and then it's going to provide a link for me. Then I'm going to go over to a web browser where John is authenticated. I'm going to refresh the page, and then I'm going to go to apps, and I'm going to go ahead and get the app. There it goes right there. Get it installed. And now it's saying, hey, and I did this intentionally. Not only do I need to give John Doe access to it via an app or explicitly in the workspace, what else do I need to do? What did I forget? Let me show you. What you also need to do, and it's a really critical step, is back on the data set, you go to security and you assign John or whoever it is to that role. This is really important that you do. If you're giving him access via a workspace, assign him to a viewer role, no other role. And then also decide if you're gonna give them access via the workspace or access via an app. If you give them access via app, you don't have to assign them in a workspace, but you still need to go onto the security for that data set and add them to one of your roles, okay? Now, if I go back over to my app, click refresh, you can see that I have control navigation on the pages using my single select and my general information. So now I can say John can only go to pages where OLS columns are excluded. And if I click it, you can see it perfectly works. Now, what if John's a really savvy guy and he calls an unknowing report consumer up that's not included in the OLS role and says, hey, can you open up the app and send me a link to this page? Will that page render for him? And will the OLS still kick in? Let's see. We're going to go over to my browser. Let's say John calls me up and he says, hey, Patrick, can you get this app for me and go to the OLS columns included page and open that page up? Send me the link to that page. So I copy it because I don't know any better. Send it to John in Teams and he opens up a browser and he's so excited. He's like, yeah, I'm going to get these addresses, and he pastes it in. Boom. While he still has access to the page itself, he does not have access to the column. So the role level security to control the navigation is not security that blocks them from accessing the page. It just controls the navigation to the pages because I've hidden all the pages. Now, if I have column level security, regardless if you have the page or not, you will not be able to see that column. All right, what do you guys think? Are you using object level security? Have you tried to set it up? Have you run into this error? Of course, I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.